Are you sick and tired of gambling your hard-earned money on Madden packs? Well, look no further than my sponsor, MMOEXP, for the cheapest and most reliable muck coins on the market. And don't forget to use code FERDY at checkout for 5% off. The link for their website will be right at the top of the description.
What's going on, guys? Today we are going to be looking at my Super Bowl promo predictions. Before we hop into it, if you are new here, hit that subscribe button. We're on the road to 20,000 subscribers. Hit the subscribe button, turn notifications. We post daily Madden 21 content. And also, do not forget to hit that like button and also leave a link for my Twitch channel down in the description. I will be live tonight over on Twitch, so if you haven't come through yet, I recommend you do. And of course, shout out to my man, TLC, for commenting the emoji on last video. Alright, so before we get started, I want to take a look back at last year's promo. To give you guys a pretty good idea of what we were thinking when making our predictions. So, here is last year's promo. There are three limited times, which was David Tyree, Franco Harris, and Steve Young, Mel Renfro. Then we had three masters last year, which were Derek Brooks, Steve Young, and Gene Upshaw. And you needed three 95s in order to create one of these 96s. So, but what we did this year is we actually bumped them all up one overall. So instead this year, the collectibles are now 96s and these masters are 97s and also the limiteds are 97s as well. So, we're going to have what, 996s. And we're going to have 697s for the past portion of the promo. And if we go to the present portion of the promo, last year we had the Super Bowl MVP. We do have some mock card arts for those two potential candidates to win this, or most likely to win it. You never know what can happen in a Super Bowl game. But we have Richard Sherman, who was a master. Tyreek Hill was a master. And you needed DeForest Buckner, Raheem, Kyle Juszczyk to create Richard Sherman. And you needed Sammy Watkins, Chris Jones, and Mitchell Schwartz to create Tyreek Hill. And our two LTDs from the present portion of the promo were Tyrann Mathieu and Arik Armstead. So two defensive limiteds. There was not a single offensive limited in the present portion of the promo. But that is basically the whole rundown on the promo from last year. Let's hop into our predictions for this year, man. Let's do it. All right, so the first set of cards we're looking at are the 96 overall collectibles that will eventually go into the 97 overall masters for the past portion of the promo. And shout out to all the people that went into making these cards. Global, Raptor, the Petalite, I'm not sure how you say that. I'm sorry if I'm butchering that name. And this guy, shout out to all you guys. I know this is very time consuming. So shout out to all the people who went into making these cards, man. I really can't thank you guys enough, man. But the first card we got is Anthony Munoz. This guy does not have a card in this year's game yet, and I feel like he's in the game every single year. So I feel like the time's kind of ticking until we get a Munoz card. Played in a Super Bowl, so I mean, this card definitely does make sense. If we head to the next card, we have Bob Sanders. This guy's definitely due. His only card right now is the card that dropped at launch. I'm not sure if his stats will look this good, but yeah, Bob Sanders will definitely be fire, man. I'm not going to lie. This card looks really, really nice. And the next card we have is Kurt Warner. Has yet to get an upgrade this year. Played in a Super Bowl. These stats look pretty accurate to me. I mean, the throw power is there. The accuracies look good throwing the run. And I mean, it all makes sense on a Kurt Warner card, to be honest, man. Kurt Warner, I can 100% see this man getting a card, dude. Next up, we have Larry Little. Right guard, also was in the game last year. Does not have a card yet this year. And nice looking stats. Right guard. I feel like we need some more offensive lineman variety in this game, to be honest. I know people don't really care about offensive linemen too much, but I feel like we definitely need some more variety. And next up, we have who's probably my favorite card that we predicted, and that is Michael Irvin. Where is Michael Irvin's card, man? I've been waiting all year for it. Is it even coming at this point? Who knows? But when this card drops, I might mess around and build a whole theme team around Michael Irvin. If you've been with me since Madden 20, you know how much I love this card. So if Michael Irvin does drop for this promo, I'd be more than excited, man. I'd be more than excited. All right, so the next man up is Reggie Bush, another card that is definitely due. And if Reggie does drop, he will without question be one of the best running backs in the game. I mean, I believe the 91 or 92 overall Reggie Bush is still used in today's game. I'm not gonna lie, people are still out here running Reggie Bush because of his archetype. And just for some reason, Reggie Bush just plays amazing. So if this card does come out, he will without question be one of the best backs in the game. Next up, we have Tracy Porter. I mean, you guys all know Tracy Porter has probably one of the most famous interceptions in Super Bowl history. You know, get Drew Brees his first ring, first and only ring, by the way. But I think Tracy Porter, another card that's due, already has a card in this year's game. Already has a power up, so I can definitely see EA kind of continuing the Tracy Porter upgrade line with this Super Bowl card. All right, next up, we have Von Miller. I definitely think that Von Miller could get a card. I mean, he's definitely due, but The one problem with Von Miller that, I mean, I guess could keep him from getting this upgrade is that he is in some legal problems right now. So maybe EA holds off. I mean, EA usually doesn't like to give player upgrades when a guy's in a legal case. I don't know what that is, but they don't like to do that. So I don't know about Von Miller, but I can definitely see it if he had a clean record. I believe they probably made this card before he had his issues, but I can still see Von Miller getting a card if they just kind of sweep it underneath the rug, you know? But yeah, Von Miller definitely do, and had one of the greatest Super Bowl performances I can remember. All right, next up, we got Warren Sapp, played on Tampa Bay. The Super Bowl's in Tampa Bay. This card just kind of makes sense. Good speed, good power, good finesse, good play rec. Warren Sapp, 96. Probably be very pricey for a defensive tackle, but if you played Madden 20, you know how good Warren Sapp played in that game. If this card drops, definitely would be a very interesting card to take a look at. And I know that Bucks Steam teams are getting very popular right now. So if you're a Bucks Steam team with that 80 speed, if they drop him that fast, I mean, you could have what, an 84 speed Warren Sapp potentially playing defensive tackle for you. That's actually crazy. All right, so now we have our 97 overall MasterCard. So it'll take three 96s in order to create one of these 97 overall cards. And the first one we got, Marcus Allen, does not have a card yet this year. Somehow, I feel like he always has a card in Madden. And just like Anthony Munoz, there's no sign of a Marcus Allen coming. Hopefully, he's the promo where he gets his card. But yeah, Marcus Allen, I mean, this one makes sense. Played in a Super Bowl, Raiders theme team. You know, EA loves giving the Raiders theme team love. So this one definitely makes sense. And he would probably be one of the better backs in the game as far as archetype, having that mix of power and juke move and spin move and stuff like that. I feel like Marcus Allen would be a really, really popular card in MUD that a lot of people would actually really, really want. All right, next up, we got Ray Lewis, another man who played in the Super Bowl, obviously. He's got two rings, I believe. Yeah, two rings for Ray Lewis. And this card, I mean, EA loves giving their middle linebacker upgrades. Ray Lewis is due, in my opinion. And this 97 overall does make sense. And Ray Lewis would definitely sell packs. I'm telling you that right now. Good speed, can play zone, the hip power, the block shit. Obviously, beats against the run. Ray Lewis would probably be the best middle linebacker in the game if a card drops looking like this, man. And for our last 97 master, we have Santonio Holmes. This one's kind of a shot in the dark. I understand that because we haven't seen Santonio in Mutt since I don't even know when the last time he was in the game. I couldn't even tell you. But one of my favorite players of all time has one of the greatest catches in Super Bowl history. So I feel like Santonio, this would be the time for EA to add Santonio back into Mutt. I'm not sure if they juice his stats like this, but if we get a Santonio Holmes card looking like this, I can guarantee you it might sell a couple packs for them, dude. All right, so now we have our limited time pass players, and the first card we're looking at is Cowboys legend Randy White. Card looks pretty solid, defensive tackle. I can definitely see EA adding a Randy White limited. Even if it's not a limited, I think that he could definitely get an upgrade at some point during this promo. All right, so next up we have Terrell Davis. Does not have a card yet this year. He's always a fan favorite. I feel like if EA did drop this Terrell Davis card, literally no one would be upset at it. Terrell Davis is an absolute legend. I would love to see him get some kind of upgrade during this promo. And for our last limited time, we have limited time Brett Favre. I know he's already very, very dominant in the game right now, and I can only imagine how expensive a limited time Brett Favre card would be. He'd probably be endgame, already has the money release. Probably would get pretty crazy abilities as well. If EA drops this limited time Brett Favre, that would be absolutely crazy, man. But hopefully they do. That'd be pretty cool to see. All right, so now we have our Super Bowl present collectibles. So it'll take three of these 96s in order to create the 97 master. And each team will have three of these collectibles and one master. So here's the first collectible we're looking at. It's for the Bucks. Chris Godwin, definitely do. Only has his blitz upgrade so far. Being a slot archetype, I think Chris Godwin would probably be one of the better wide receivers in the game. I would not be opposed to getting a Chris Godwin card. I'll tell you that right now. Next up, we got Ryan Jensen. And last year, EA did give offensive linemen love when it came to these collectibles. So I can definitely see Ryan Jensen getting this upgrade. I don't think the Chiefs are going to get the offensive lineman because they don't really have an O-lineman that is really prominent and would really deserve a 96 like the Buccaneers do. So I can definitely see Ryan Jensen getting this card. A very key part of the Buccaneers offense and the run game and stuff like that. And I believe he only has his core elite right now. So Ryan Jensen, this upgrade definitely makes sense for this promo. All right, so next up we have fan favorite Vita Vea. I'm not sure how good this card would actually be, but definitely a fun card to use and play against for sure. So Vita Vea, I can definitely see him getting the Super Bowl card. If it's not him, maybe, you know, Ndamukong Suh gets it or someone like that. But a Vita Vea upgrade would be super cool in this promo. All right, so now we have the Chiefs collectibles, and the first card we got is Anthony Sherman. This is a man I can definitely see getting the upgrade. Last year, EA did show love to Kyle Juszczyk, and Sherman is definitely due, so I can definitely see Sherman getting this upgrade, man, without question. All right, so next up, we have Rashad Breeland. If he does not get this upgrade, I think that either him or Charvarius Ward are definitely due for this upgrade, so it kind of depends on who EA wants to pick, but either of the cornerbacks are definitely due. Not L'Jarius Sneed though. L'Jarius, he's probably one of the best corners in Mutt right now. But Breeland probably wouldn't be that great apart from being on a Chiefs theme team, but probably a pretty good tackler. And I feel like EA might show Breeland love over Ward because Breeland did guard Stephon Diggs last week and did a pretty decent job. So I'm going to go Rashad Breeland for this upgrade. And for the last collectible, we have Mecole Hardman. 97 speed, good jumping, good route running. Did have that muffed punt. I mean, muffed punt in the playoff game, but then turned it around, had the touchdown, had the nice end around. And Mecole Hardman's best card is still a gold. So I think that he's definitely due. Either him or Sammy, but I think that Mecole will probably get this card over Sammy this year. They gave it to Sammy last year, so I think that Mecole could definitely get it this year. All right, so next up, we have our 297 overall Masters. The first card we got is Shaq Barrett. This man does not have an upgrade since, I believe, either Team of the Week 1 or 2. I'm not sure which week it was, but all I'm going to say, it was very early in the year. I think Shaq Barrett's definitely due, makes a big impact on this Tampa Bay Buccaneers defense. So I can definitely see EA showing the Buccaneers some love. And I don't think the defensive master is going to be for the Chiefs because I don't know who on the Chiefs would actually deserve a 97 overall master card. But I do think 100% that because the Chiefs won, Travis Kelce will get this card. I think that EA did wait to see if the Chiefs won or lost before either giving Waller the tight end team of the year or giving Kelce the tight end team of the year. But I think Kelce will be your Chiefs 97 overall offensive master without question. Will he be better than Waller? I don't know. But if you did use Travis Kelce's team, I mean, not team of the year, Travis Kelce's most feared card earlier in the year, that card played well above his overall. So I could see Kelce probably being an endgame tight end. Even though he might be a little bit slow, I think Travis Kelce will be an amazing master card. I'm not going to lie. Definitely deserves it. Had an amazing season. A record-breaking season for sure. Travis Kelce definitely deserves some kind of upgrade soon, man. All right, so now we have our two MVP mock-up card arts. So we have the Patrick Mahomes and the Tom Brady. Either card would honestly be amazing. Tom Brady's actually doesn't play that bad in Mutt. And that would mean Tom Brady has Gunslinger, which is what everyone kind of wants. So here are the two, you know, MVP mock arts. As you guys know, if you are new to Mutt, the Super Bowl MVP is always the first Gold 99 of the year. All right, so now we have our two defensive limited times that were Tyrann Mathieu and Arik Armstead last year. The first one, Frank Clark, definitely due for an upgrade. I guess he's probably one of the better players on the Chiefs defense that does not have an upgrade yet. So I'm going with Frank Clark for one of the limiteds. And for the Buccaneers limited, there were a lot of different options, but I'm going with Sean Murphy Bunting. Already has a rising star upgrade. It easily could have been like Whitehead or one of those safeties that they have out there, but I think Murphy Bunting might get this upgrade. Would probably be pretty good. Hopefully they do add a power up with Murphy Bunting, but I mean, I like both these limited cards. Frank Clark and Murphy Bunting would both be really, really good. That Frank Clark card last year played really, really well, so I could definitely see them adding a Frank Clark this year. I believe he only has his core elite, and Murphy Bunting only has a 90 overall upgrade, and he had an interception in that game versus Aaron Rodgers, didn't he, too, as well. So I think that EA might show Murphy Bunting some love. All right, guys, so that is going to do it for today's predictions. If you have any predictions yourself, feel free to comment them down below. I'll be responding to all you guys down in the comment section. I believe we went over all the cards, all 20-something of them. And, of course, shout out to everyone that went into making these cards, man. I really can't say thank you enough. But, yeah, these cards look amazing, man. So, yeah, if you guys are still watching, let's comment the box emoji for a chance to be shouted out in the next video. And if you are new here, hit that subscribe button, turn notifications. We post daily Madden 21 content. And as always, I'll see you boys in the next one.